Many people feel very anxious in their relationship because their partner avoids emotional intimacy. Despite how frustrating the avoidant partner may appear, not everything can be blamed on them. Any relationship comprises a dynamic between two individuals. And in the context of both partners, problems within the relationship have to be examined. People who take an avoidant stance in relationships, if sufficiently motivated and with their partner's help, can become more open to greater intimacy, communication, and closeness. Here are the list that can help dealing with an avoidant partner. Number 1. Give them plenty of space. If they need to withdraw, then let them. If you pursue people who need space, they will likely run even faster or turn and fight. So, if avoidant partners withdraw, allow them. Letting them go temporarily may be painful, but it is likely that pursuing them will take even longer before they come back. People with avoidant attachment have often normalized being independent, alone, and isolated. They may take some pride in this because it's become their reality, and it's the way they find power in it. Number 2. Don't take it personally. This isn't about you. Avoidant partners seek distance out of self-protection. They are afraid of losing themselves. Again, this isn't about you. You don't have to take it on if an avoidant partner seems too critical of you. Remember, your partner, too, is probably self-critical. Self-protective behaviors can keep interactions feeling superficial. This isn't because avoidant folks don't want connection, it's because connection is terrifying for them. The times they may have connected in the past might have been painful for them, and risking that pain again doesn't feel like an option. Number 3. Instead of complaining about what you do not want, ask what you want. Complaints, in disguise, are desires and longings. Few of us like it when someone complained about us. When someone we care about voices what they desire, most of us become more responsive. Number 4. Offer understanding. In relationships, one quality often in short supply is listening. Be open to hearing about the feelings and problems of your partners, however they are expressed. Be compassionate and kind. Listen to understand a problem, not to fix it. Number 5. Compromise. Compromise can be very important. In relationships, there must be compromises. Good compromises help you and your partner grow together as a team. They foster trust, accountability, consistency, and security in your relationship. Number 6. Be dependable and reliable. Avoidant partners expect to be disappointed. That makes it more important that you do what you've promised. Don't make promises that you can't keep. Number 7. Set healthy boundaries and tell your partner what you need and what you won't tolerate. Let your partner know you expect to be respected. Tell your partner what you need and what you won't tolerate. Love does not mean accepting dysfunctional behavior. Number 8. Respect your differences. Recognize that your partner's pace may be slower than yours, but that does not necessarily mean your partner does not want to be with you. Number 9. Acknowledge that both of you may have unrealistic fantasies. Your avoidant partner may have a fantasy of a perfect mate who meets all of his or her needs. You might have a fantasy of a perfect relationship in which you never feel disappointed or lonely. Fantasy is not realistic either. Number 10. Be mindful of how you express strong emotions with your partner. You have to be able to convey your feelings and wishes to your partner. But intensely delivered emotional expressions often overwhelm avoidant partner. Because they can withdraw or shut down, they can't hear your message. If you convey your feelings honestly and openly, but in a moderate tone, you are more likely to be heard. Number 11. Do not try to change your partner or rescue him. It is fruitless to try to alter somebody's basic attachment style. It may, however, be that an avoidant partner can become more willing to risk intimacy and closeness over time in a safe relationship. Number 12. connection and intense emotions actually trigger the fight, freeze part of their brains. When they witness their partner having a big emotion, or when intimacy increases in a relationship, it can trigger a fight or their brain freezes. They learned that big feelings meant something was wrong because big feelings weren't allowed. Number 13. Recognize limitations. Avoidant partners may need more personal time and take more distance than you might like. That may never change. No partner is perfect. Number 14. Give plenty of space. When things are going well and you feel your partner coming closer, it may be tempting to open the floodgates and voice all your pent-up desires for closeness. You may worry that the open door could close at any moment, and seek to say everything you have stored up while you can. However, this is often counterproductive. Instead, enjoy your partner's efforts to get close without overwhelming the moment. Number 15. Don't get stuck in rigid roles. If an avoidant partner is always the one distancing or seeking independence, and you are always seeking closeness, you can become trapped in those roles. There are probably times when you desire independence and space, just as there are times avoidant partners desire closeness. Number 16. They still have feelings. They love people. There is a part of them that desperately wants to connect in a deeper way. However, because of early relationships, cultural or familial beliefs, or general lack of emotional resonance or reciprocity from the important attachment figures in their lives, people with the avoidant style are terrified of connecting. They may have put themselves out there to connect previously and were shut down emotionally, reinforcing the idea that being expressive and open is unsafe. Number 17. People with an avoidant style have a more difficult time naming feelings. In their upbringing, they may have internalized the belief that their feelings were not welcome. So they learned how to operate in the world by compartmentalizing their emotions and spending more time in their minds. Sometimes they even have a difficult time recognizing they have feelings. Hope you enjoy the video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.